Hello everyone, welcome to BrainBuzz Academy. This is me, Umia Salma, presenting you today's 21st as well as 22nd March current affairs. Right? So here I will be discussing about the current affairs. Right? So in BrainBuzz Academy, we provide you current affairs as well as general awareness for SSC, banking, railways, as well as other state examinations and PSU as well. If you are a student who is preparing for APPSC or TSPSC, you can read the current affairs in Telugu medium too. See, BrainBuzz Academy also has a website where you can find general awareness and current affairs, right? And you can download the PDF of everyday current affairs, right? Okay. So now let me go directly into the lesson. So let me see how many of you people are live. Let me now start the lesson. So we will be discussing both 21st as well as 22nd current affairs, right? Okay. Now the first current affairs is Ministry of Defense signs ₹880 crore contract for Negave 7.62x51mm, right? This is the dimensions of the light machine guns, which is an Israel weapon, which is from Israeli weapon industries, right? The name is Negev, right? So these Ministry of Defense, see who is the Minister of Defense? Rajnath Singh, right? So he is the total Ministry of Defense has signed a agreement, a contract for Negev 7.62x51mm light machine guns with Israeli weapon industries, right? So let us go in detail. So you can see the Negev weapon, which is 7.562x51mm. So here we see Defense Minister Rajnath Singh have given approval to the acquisition wing of Ministry of Defense for a capital acquisition contract with Israel Weapons Industries, that is IWI, Israel Weapon Industries, as an Israeli firearms manufacturer. Okay, the contract enables the procurement of 16,479 Negev, that is 7.62x51mm, which we have already discussed. It is a light machine gun, which is at a cost of 880 crore. See, these weapons are procured under the fast track procedure, so it will be under the fast track procedure. So coming, let us now discuss about the Negev, about the Negev gun, right? The name is Negev. These are the dimensions. So it is a combat proven weapon and is used by several countries till now, right? This LMG, that is a light machine gun, okay, greatly enhance the casualty and range of soldiers. So its other features include semi-automatic and fully automatic modes for firing and to throw grenades. See here, see the name, why it is mentioned as light machine gun. You know, in defense forces, while you are recruiting for army, so they will be checking your height as well as body measurements, BMI. Because see, when you are firing, you need to take the reaction of the gun as well, right? You need to have a certain height as well as your BMI should be proper. So in order to avoid all this is a light machine gun. So it also takes a good reaction when you are firing, right? So this light machine gun, which is also light, right, which enhance the casualty of and range of a soldier easily, okay. It other features are, it is semi-automatic as well as fully automatic modes, both for firing as well as throwing grenades. So these were used by many other countries. So the name is Negev gun. Now let us go to the other topic of, so coming to the Ministry of Defense. So let us know what are the ministries that comes under the Ministry of Defense. First, the Minister of State is Sripad S.O. Naik. The Minister for Defense Central is the Minister for Defense is Rajnath Singh. And for State is Sri Prasad S.O. Naik. Coming to four departments which comes under the Ministry of Defense, that is Department of Defense DOD, Department of Defense Production DDP, as well as Department of Ex-Servicemen Welfare DESW, and the Defense Research and Development Organization DRDO, right? So all these departments comes under the Ministry of Defense. Now let us move on to the other topic of the current affairs. Here the Finance Commission sets up a committee to review fiscal consolidation roadmap. So, our finance minister, Nirmala Sitharaman, has set up a committee to review fiscal deficit or consolidation roadmap. Let us now discuss in detail about the fiscal deficit. Here, it is a 8-member committee, right? See, if you are studying for bank examinations, it is very important. So, right, it is an 8-member committee and it is set up by the finance commission to review the fiscal consolidation roadmap of state as well as the central government. Here, this is a, our present is the 17th finance commission, right? This committee is headed by the 15th finance commission chairman N.K. Singh, right? So, see, this is the 15th, N.K. Singh is the chairman of 15th finance commission. Now, this committee, which is an 8-member committee, will be headed by the N.K. Singh. Coming to the next important point here, it considers all of India's explicit and measurable debt. It will make recommendations on the definition of deficit as well as debt of central government, overall state government, as well as general government and PSUs, which are at government levels. Right? And by bringing the consistency between the definition of debt as well as the deficit. Right? Debt is known as stock and deficit is known as flow. So, it brings the consistency between the definition of debt as well as deficit. So, this is the Finance Commission which has set up a committee, which is an 8-member committee and chaired by the N.K. Singh, who is the previous chairman of 15th Finance Commission. Now, let us move on to the another important topic of 21st March current affairs. Right? Here, Prime Minister Narendra Modi formed COVID-19 Economic Response Task Force headed by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharam. So, recently our Prime Minister has formed a COVID-19 Economic Response Task Force, which will be headed by our Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. Right? Now, let us move here. The Prime Minister Narendra Modi has declared the formulation of COVID-19 Economic Response Task Force to be led by the our Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. Its main objective is to tackle the economic challenges arising out of novel coronavirus outbreak. So, coming to the duties of these task force, here the task force is mandated to execute measures to reduce the economic difficulties facing by various public and private sectors. It should maintain a regular touch with all the stakeholders, take their feedback and make decisions accordingly. So, it is a task force for the economic challenges due to the COVID-19. So, which is headed by Nirmala Sitharaman, the chairman. Okay? Chairman is Nirmala Sitharaman. These are the duties of the task force which they need to consider. Coming to the next topic. See here, SIDBI, Small Investment Development Bank of India, SIDBI, to launch a special train known as Swavalambam Express on June 5th, 2020 for new entrepreneurs. So, this is the train which we are launching on June 5th, 2020. The train name is Swavalamban Express, which is for the new entrepreneurs who is launching it, SIDBI, Small Investment Development Bank of India. So here, the Small Industries Development Bank of India, a development financial institution in India engaged in the promotion, financing and development of micro, small and medium entrepreneurs, MSMEs, which has decided to launch a special train known as Swavalamban Express on June 5th, 2020 to empower budding entrepreneurs under its mission Swalamban. Right? This is about the Swalamban Express. In order to empower the budding entrepreneurs who are starting up their entrepreneurship, the mission is known as Swalamban. Excuse me. See, this train will visit 11 cities in 15 days. So, it will cover a 7,000 kilometers journey, which is around 20 workshops. Right, and interactions will be held to promote entrepreneurial culture among the youth about financial as well as non-financial aspects of enterprise running. Coming to here, the participants will be at the age of 20 to 35 years, not more than 25. Right, this train will start from Lucknow because the headquarters of SIDBI is in Lucknow, which is in Uttar Pradesh, right? This train will be starting from Lucknow. The train journey will also focus on the Prime Minister Narendra Modi's vision of becoming a $5 trillion economy by 2024 to 2025, right? This is about the SIDBI launching Swalamban Express, which will be started on June 5th, 2020 in order to empower the entrepreneurs, right? Which will be up to the age gap of 20 to 35 years. Here, the journey, total journey is about 7,000 kilometers, which will take 15 days and will round up all the 11 cities. It will start from Lucknow. Now, let us move on to the other topic, that is, the Fitch Ratings cuts India's growth forecast to 5.1% for the financial year 21 from 5.6%. So, it has reduced from 5.6% to 5.1%. Okay. Shivaji, how long time does the class? Okay, just now it has started. You can continue from here too. So, good morning. Good morning. So, now coming to Fitch Ratings, if you are preparing for bank examinations, these Fitch Ratings, Moody, as well as SI growth forecast will be very important, right? Moody's forecast, right? As well as Fitch forecast for the financial year, right? So, this Fitch rating has said, it said that it has cut the India's growth forecast for to 5.1% from the 5.6%. Let us know in detail. See, here, the Fitch Ratings, which is on Global Economic Outlook 2020, has declined India's growth forecast to 5.1% for the financial year 2020 to 2021 due to the coronavirus outbreak, which is likely to impact business investment. So, as well as the exports. For the financial year 2021 to 2022, Fitch has projected India's growth at 6.4%. Remember, it is for the next year, that is for 2021 to 2022. And this is for this year, that is 2020 to 2021, which is for 5.1%. First, the Fitch has said that it will be up to 5.6% due to COVID outbreak. It has reduced to 5.1%, India's growth rate. Right? Due to coronavirus crisis, Fitch Ratings lowered the growth rates for 2020 to 1.3% from 2.5%, which is predicted in last year, that is in December 2019. So, this is about the Fitch Ratings. If you are studying for bank, so it is important to remember the growth forecast ratings by each companies. Okay. Now, let us move on to other topic. ICICI Lombard introduced COVID-19 protection card for coronavirus positive case. See, if else you are having a COVID-19 positive case, ICICI Lombard has introduced the COVID-19 protection card for coronavirus. Now, let us move on to the topic. ICICI, which is known as Industrial Credit as well as Investment Corporation of India. See, these abbreviations are also important, right? Lombard, a private sector non-life insurance company, has introduced a one-year-long COVID-19 protection cover at a premium of ₹149. It has launched in group insurance mode. This is the policy which pay all 100% of the sum insured in the COVID-19 positive individual, irrespective of hospital expenses. So it will take care of all these. Irrespective of all the hospitalization expenses, the premium coverage of ₹149 for 1 year long. See, the age gap will be of 18 to 75 years and is eligible for, if a person is from 18 to 75 years, then only he will be eligible for the COVID-19 protection cover, which is launched by ICICI Lombard for 1 year long of at a premium of ₹149, right? So, now coming to the next topic. See, most of the current affairs will be focused on COVID-19 only. Now, let us move on to the next one. So, coming to the achievements here. Okay. Coming to the achievements, here you see Indian mountaineer Satyarup Siddhanta enters Limca Book of Records. So, see, do share with your friends. Please share this video with your friends and press the like button, right? Now, Indian mountaineer Satyarup Siddhanta enters Limca Book of Records. See, why did he enter? He is a mountaineer, right? He hails from Tamil Nadu. Now, see, this Satyarup Siddhanta is an Indian mountaineer who hails from Kolkata, West Bengal, who is 37 years old, who has entered the Limca Book of Records for his extraordinary achievements, and he is the first Indian to climb the highest volcanoes, right? highest volcanoes of each of the 7 continents. So he has entered the Inca Book of Records for climbing highest volcanoes of each 7 continents. Now, he also holds the record of the youngest mountaineer in the world to climb both 7 peaks as well as 7 volcanic summits. See, Satyarup Siddhanta completed his 7 summits as well as 7 volcanic summits in January 2019 and was recognized by LBR. So, that is Limca Book of Records. He has completed the summit in January 2019. Now, he was recognized by the Limca Book of Records and was honored. So, he is the first Indian to climb the all the highest volcanoes in all 7 countries. Okay. Any information about GDP by Moody's? Yeah. Until the end of class, I will be informing you about the Moody's growth forecast, right? See, all the growth forecasts will lie from 4.8 to 5.1% only. Even if you have option above 5.1%, you cannot keep it, right? So, all the forecasts given by each company is from 4.8% to 5.1%. I will be telling you at the end of session, right? So, coming to RBI, appoints R. Gandhi as well as Anand Gopalakrishnan as an additional directors of S Bank. So, recently S Bank was in crisis, right? So, it now S Bank has the new directors are Ramasubramanian Gandhi, who is a former RBI deputy governor, and Anand Narayan Gopalakrishnan is an associate professor of SPJN Institute of Management and Research. So, in this exercise of powers under the S Bank Limited Reconstruction Scheme 2020 and the Banking Regulation Act 1941, see, the RBI has appointed these two as the additional directors of the S Bank. Institute of Management, see, on the board of private sector lender S Bank for a period of 2 years. So, they will be for a tenure of 2 years. With the effect from March 26, 2020, right? So this is about the S Bank, who are the additional directors, right? So recently SBI has 49% stakeholding in the S Bank. Now coming to the next one, coming to the obituary of 21st March current affairs, here Indian football legend PK Banerjee passed away at the age of 83. Here, Indian football player Pradeep Kumar Banerjee passed away at the age of 83 in Kolkata, West Bengal. He was born on June 3, 1936 in Jalpaiguri, West Bengal. He has scored 65 international goals in 84 appearances for national team and also won Asian Games gold medalist in 1962, won the gold medal in Asia Games which is in 1992 which were held in Jakarta, right? And also won FIFA awarded him. FIFA is Federation International de Football Association, awarded him the Continental Order of Merit in the year 2004. Maybe this award will be important for the examination, that is the FIFA award. Now coming to the next topic, that is a new book has entitled on Messiah Modi, A Great Tale of Expectations, penned by Talwin Singh, has been released. So, this is a new book on Modi, Prime Minister Modi, the name which was written by Talwin Singh, right? The name is Messiah Modi. Now, in detail, we see, it is a great tale of expectations from the Modi, which is authored by our senior journalist, Talwin Singh. See, coming to the important points about this book, you have, this book is published by HarperCollins India, which narrates it. Early support for Modi, the candidate by the author, once a great supporter of the government. Right? It also talks about the helpless dissatisfaction with PM, his cabinet, and the story of his first time as a journey from mob lynching, right? Which was took place in Jammu and Kashmir, as well as in other North Indian states, right? As well as demonetization up to Article 370, which was recently in Jammu and Kashmir, and the most controversial law, citizenship amendment, as well as implementation of NRC, that is National Register of Citizens, and the promises he made is his first term. So, you know, for all these, the dissatisfactions she had once she was a great supporter of Modi. See, the author also stated that Modi is the most isolated PM that she have seen in the Delhi. So, this is about the Messiah Modi, A Great Tale of Expectations, right? So, which was penned by Talwin Singh. So, coming to the important days, we have So here you can see for 2021, financial year 2021, the Moody's growth rate is 5.8%, right? It has cut to 5.3% from a previous estimate 5.4. This year, for the year 2021, it has cut to 5.3 from 5.4, right? For the year 2021, Moody's has expect, right? For the year financial year 2021, the estimate growth is about 5.8%. Why it has reduced? Because of the COVID outbreak. This is about the Moody forecast, right? Now coming to the important days, that is World Sparrow Day 2020, right? The World Sparrows Day will be celebrated every year on 20 March. Now let us discuss why this Sparrow Day is being celebrated, right? See, this is observed every year on March 20 and was first celebrated in the year 2010. Okay, Maruti, I am Telugu medium. Okay, the much you learn, even I am not perfect in English, right? The more you speak and the more you talk, you write, you will get the language, right? It is observed every year on March 20 and was first celebrated in the year 2010, which was initiated by Nature Forever Society, NFS. See, Maruti, you can also take the website in BrainBuzz Academy website. You also can have the current affairs in Telugu medium too, right? Where you can properly understand it, right? Then, okay, this day is celebrated globally to spread awareness about the importance of sparrows and their major functional observational values. So, in order for this, see, it is celebrated to spread awareness about the importance of sparrows in our society and their major functional conservation values. The theme of World Sparrow Day is I Love Sparrows. This theme aims to highlight the love that people have for sparrows. See, this day is celebrated to use it as a platform for conserving sparrows and urban biodiversity. How sparrows was declared as the state bird of Delhi in the year 2012. So, as summer season is coming, please put some water as well as some greens on your balconies, right, for the birds. Now, this is about the World Sparrow Day 2020, which will be celebrating on March 10th. First, it was celebrated in the year 2010. Theme is I Love Sparrows. And the state bird of, it had made the state bird of Delhi in the year 2012. Now, coming to the other important day, International Day of Happiness, right? We will be celebrating International Day of Happiness on the year March 20th. So, this day creates the awareness of importance of happiness in everyone's life around the world. The theme of the year is happiness for all together. The theme also conveys to promote and advance worldwide solidarity, unity and winning the global fight against COVID-19 coronavirus disease. So as this theme is related to COVID-19, maybe this theme may come in the examination. It is happiness for all together. It helps to convey and also promote the advance worldwide solidarity and unity in winning the global fight against COVID-19. So, it is celebrated every year on March 20, right? Coming to the next topic, that is World Day of Theatre for Children and Young People 2020 is celebrated on 20th March. Take a child to the nearest World Theatre Day. So, in order to get them about the arts as well as theatre arts, right? It is celebrated in the World Day of Theatre for Children and Young People. So it is an ASSITEJ, that is International Association of Theatre for Children and Young People campaign, and celebrates the performing arts for children and young people worldwide. See, the main purpose of this day is to draw attention of wider picture to the public about the children's and young people's theatre. For the children, it is promoted and celebrated through the slogan, Take a Child to a Theatre Today, which is a call to parents, grandparents and as well as guardians to take the children in their care to the theatre on the day, right? So, this is mainly focused on the art and culture, theatre arts, culture, acting, all about this, right? So, this is about the World Theatre Day for the children and young people. Coming to the next topic, this is the state current affairs, right? Jammu and Kashmir government has recently set up a social and educational BC commission. Now let us, these commissions are important, right? So in detail we see Jammu and Kashmir government set up and socially as well as educationally backward classes commission, which will be held by retired Justice G.D. Sharma to examine the social as well as educational. To examine the social and educational backwardness of various backward classes peoples, Dalits in the Union Territory. Right? This is about the Jammu and Kashmir, which has recently set up a commission for socially as well as educationally backward classes commission. The commission will be headed by the retired Chief Justice G.D. Sharma. Now coming to the 22nd March current affairs. The first one is new draft defense procurement procedure 2020 has unveiled recently by our Defense Minister Rajnath Singh. Here you see what is new draft, right? Here we see Union Defense Minister has now proposed a new draft defense procurement procedure DPP 2020 feature promotion of indigenous manufacturing during a meet in New Delhi. The proposed DPP 2020 will come into effect from 1st April 2020 by replacing DPP 2016. So earlier it was DPP 2016, that is Draft Defense Procurement Procedure. Now the proposed one is DPP 2020. It would remain in force till 31st March 2025. Until 2025 it will be the same. Again the next DPP will be announced. So coming to about this DPP 2020, this draft has been finalized by a high-level committee headed by the Apurva Chandra, who is a Director General of Acquisition for Ministry of Defense, that was set up in August 2019. A total of 47 amendments carried out as a part of business process re-engineering to draft DPP 2020. So total 47 amendments has been taken place, which was first in 2016. For this 2016 one, total 47 amendments has been done and the new DPP 2020 has procurement procedure, draft defense procurement procedure has been announced. And the next it will be on the year 2025, right? This is about the DPP 2020. Coming to the Ministry of Defense, I also said about the departments which comes under the Ministry of Defense. Now coming to the next topic. Janata curfew from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. on March 22nd, 2020 will be, was requested by PM Modi, right? So, I hope everyone is following Janata curfew today, right? So, maintain social distancing. Now, let us see what is about Janata curfew. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has declared Janata curfew or citizen curfew on Sunday, that is on March 23rd, 2020 today. In the wake of rising, in the wake of rising COVID-19 cases in India. In this regard, it is in Indian nationals must stay at home from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. on Sunday. Coming to the important points, the reasons are behind this curfew is to halt the expansion of coronavirus as there is a no cure for this. So in order to remain healthy, avoiding crowds as well as social distancing is necessary. Here, people working in emergency as essential services such as police, medical services, home media, home delivery, firefighting and serving the nation, etc. are excluded from the Janata curfew. Right? It should be noted that the coronavirus has affected more countries than World War I and World War II. So, remember this important point. It should be noted that the coronavirus has affected more countries than World War I as well as World War II. So it is more powerful than the World War I and World War II. So we need to maintain the Janata curfew, which was that is on today from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. Coming to the next topic, we have TriFed launches Tech for Tribals program to bring technology to tribal entrepreneurs. See, here TriFed has launched the Tech for Tribals. It is a 30-day long capacity building program called Tech for Tribal, which has been launched by the Tribal Cooperative Marketing Development Federation of India, TriFed. Tribal Cooperative Marketing Development Federation of India, which works under the Ministry of Tribal Affairs in association with IIT Kanpur, IIT Roorkee, IIT Indore, Kalinga Institute of Social Science, Bhubaneswar, Odisha and Sri Jaipur, Rajasthan, in order to provide entrepreneurship skills to tribal people. See, our Union Minister for Tribals is Arjun Munda. Recently, I have also said that Arjun Munda was also the president of Archery's Association of India, who was also in news for the asking the Ministry of Home Affairs for inclusion of Ladakh in the 6th schedule. So in the 6th schedule, the states are Assam, Tripura, Mizoram and Meghalaya, right? Now coming to the 3 lakhs tribal people will be benefited by this program about Pradhan Mantri Man Dhan Yojana, not Jan Dhan, Man Dhan Yojana, which was launched in the year 2018. It aims to boost tribal producer companies. TRIFED is a nodal agency for the implementing this scheme. Coming to the tribe, that is TRIFED, its headquarters is located in New Delhi. Headquarters is in, for Ministry of Tribal Affairs, headquarters is in New Delhi and Union Minister is Arjun Munda. Now coming to next one. Here, according to the World Happiness Report 2020, which is given by United Nations, India ranks in the 144th position, right? Finland tops. So, the top country may also be asked in the question, not only the rank of India, but also the countries which were in the top, according to the report. Now, the United Nations has recently released the 8th World Happiness Report 2020 to measure the happiness of people, 156 countries, where India 3.573 ranks in the 143. See, these are the marks of India, 3.573, which ranks in 144th position. Whereas for Finland, the points are 7.809, for India 3.573. See, there is a more gap, right? Where Finland tops, right? And India is in 144th position. See, remember, Finland has topped for the third time. Right? The survey ranks the countries using Gallup World Poll, GDP levels, life expectancy, as well as generosity, social support, freedom and corruption income. So, keeping all these points in remembrance, they will be declaring the ranks and points of the different countries. See, this year's report mainly focuses on happiness in the environment, especially in case of social, urban, rural and natural areas, and also links happiness and sustainable development. So, this is the first time in India has ranked among the least happiness in countries. So, remember, maybe this question will be asked. This is the first time in India where India has been ranked in the low least happiness countries. Coming about the United Nations, the main objective of UN is to maintain international peace and security and develop friendly relations among nations and to promote social progress, better living standards as well as human rights. Its headquarters is located in New York, which is in United States. Secretary General is Antonio Guterres. This is about UN and this is about the World Happiness Report 2020, where India has ranked 144th position and Finland has topped with 7.809 points, and this is the first time where India has ranked in the least happiness country, right? So, as everyone knew about the Madhya Pradesh political crisis, right? Here, Jyotiraditya Sindha has resigned. Now, Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Kamal Nath resigns as a Chief Minister. Here, he has submitted his resignation to MP Governor Lalji Tandon at Raj Bhavan, Bhopal, MP, ahead of the scheduled protest ordered by the Supreme Court in the State Assembly. The Governor appointed the resignation of INC, that is Indian National Congress government led by Kamal Nath. So here, after the resignation of Jyotiraditya Sindhya and his associate 22 MLA members of Legislative Assemblies from Congress Party, Kamal Nath was unable to prove the majority. Here, the Legislative of MP has total 230 MLAs, right? Out of which 24 seats were vacant. A majority of houses now present 206 MLAs, which will require the majority of 104. So, BJP is getting a majority of 107, whereas for Congress, total 99. Total seats of Congress are 92. So, excluding Jyotiraditya Sindhya as well as 22 other MLAs, and it has got the partnership with Bahujan Samajwadi Party, Bahujan Party, right? And total concluding it to 99. The total support for Congress is 99 INC, for BJP it is 107. So, obviously, it is more for BJP. So, before the party, so here, he has resigned as a CM. Now, he will be continuing as a CM until the next CM will be appointed. So, Kamal Nath will be continuing as a CM until the next CM will be appointed. Coming to Madhya Pradesh, capital is Madhya Pradesh, governor is Lalji Tandon. Now coming to next topic, that is science and technology. Now recently in current affairs, the science and technology is having a great weightage, right? NASA CNEOs detects 4 asteroids approaching the Earth. Here, that is National Aeronautical as well as Space Administration's NASA Center for Near Earth Object Studies, CNEOS, identifies 4 asteroids, namely 2020 FK, 2020 FS, 2020 DP4 and 2020 FFI, approaching the Earth, which follows Earth intersecting orbit. So now let us know about the each and every asteroid. Here, this 2020 FK asteroid is the smallest of all the 4 with a diameter of 43 feet. Here, this 2020 DP4 asteroid is the largest of the 4. See, this DP4 is largest of all 4 and FK is smallest of all 4 and is large enough to hit nearly 12 limousines with a diameter of 180 feet. And coming to 2020 FFI asteroid, which is 48 feet in diameter. The 2020 FS asteroid is 56 in diameter. This is about the each and every asteroid, which was recently discovered by CNEOs, which is Center for Near Earth Object Studies by NASA. Now coming to other science and technology. Here, important days, we have World Poetry Day, which we will be celebrating every year on March 21st. So it is observed in order to encourage people to read, write, teach, publish poetry as well as to recognize poetry's unique ability which captures the creative spirit of human mind. And its aim is to support the linguistic diversity by poetic expression. Okay. Dadra Nagar Haveli as well as Daman and Diu both include one union territory bill. So I will be explaining in the next class, right? So for this bill, it takes a one class, separate class, right? So I will be discussing in the separate class, right? So this is about 21st as well as 22nd current affairs. So I will be discussing all the events related to this only, right? In the next class, I will be surely discussing about the bill. Okay. Now let us see. Here, coming to World Poetry Day, this linguistic diversity by poetic expression as well as increase the chance of endangered language to be heard. The day was designated by United Nations Educational, Scientific as well as Cultural Organization, which is UNESCO, in its 30th General Conference, which was held in Paris at 1999. So, World Poetry Day, March 21st, in order to encourage people to read, write and teach as well as publish poetry. The next important day is World International Day for Elimination of Racial Discrimination 2020. So why this Racial Discrimination Day will be celebrated? Let us know about this. See when the day remembers the Sharpeville massacre, which was took place on 21st March 1960, which involved killing of 69 people by the police at a peaceful demonstration against the apartheid regime, which is a regime which embraced racial discrimination in Sharpeville, South Africa. The United Nations General Assembly proclaimed the day as the United Nations of Observance in 1966. In order for this, the International Day of for the Elimination of Racial Discrimination is observed annually on March 21st in order to raise awareness about the negative consequences of the racial discrimination. See, this year also marks the midterm review of the International Decade for People of African Descent 2015-2024. Now, it is present 2020, right, which was undertaken by the Human Rights Council in Geneva as a part of its 43rd session in the theme. And the theme is People of African Descent, Recognition, Justice and Development. Another day, important day is International Day of Forest, that is, which will be celebrating on March 21st. So this will be very important according to environmental affairs also in case of current affairs, right? World Forestry Day, March 21st. See, this is the International Day of Forest and is observed annually on March 21st to raise awareness of importance of all types of forests and of trees outside the forest. Coming to the theme of the year 2020, Forest and Biodiversity. The United Nations General Assembly proclaimed March 21st as the International Day of Forest from the year 2012, and the day has been observed since 2013. So, since from 2013, we will be celebrating the Indian International Day of Forest, World Forestry Day. See, on this day, The countries are encouraged to undertake local, national and international efforts to organize activities such as tree planting, campaigns, symposiums as well as wildlife education. So this is about the World Forest Day. So coming to the International Day of Nowruz 2020, which will be celebrated on March 21st. So I will be telling you briefly about this. Nowruz is a festival celebrated by the Parsis like a new year, right? So Telugu people will be celebrating as Ugadi as new year, right? Whereas Marathi Gudi Padwa. In the same way, Parsi people will be celebrating the Day of Nowruz as a new year. So it is an Iranian new year or Persian new year, which will be celebrated worldwide by various ethno-linguistic groups. The United Nations General Assembly recognized March 27th as International Day of Nowruz in 2010. Yeah, everyday PDF will be, Fanny Kumar, everyday PDF will be available in our website to download. So each and every day current affairs, you can download in PDF form. Okay. This Nowruz festival has also roots in Zoroastrianism and monotheistic religion, which originated in ancient Iran. So, International Day of Nowruz will be celebrated on March 21st. So, it is why it is celebrated. It is a day of vernal equinox and marks the beginning of spring in northern hemisphere. So, it marks as the first day of first month of Farvardin of Iranian as well as Afghanistan calendars. This is about the Persian New Year, International Day of Nowruz. So, all this is about the... See, coming to Down Syndrome Day, it is the most important day, right? World Down Syndrome Day, which is celebrated on March 21st. So, remember on March 21st, there are many current affairs, right? Many important days. On March 21st, 2020, World Down Syndrome Day has been observed and the theme is We Decide. The day aims to raise awareness as well as to provide support to the patients suffering from Down Syndrome, a congenital disorder which is caused by having an extra 21st chromosome. So, as they have the extra chromosome, 21st chromosome, they have the Down Syndrome. See, this day was first recognized by WHO. Headquarters is in Geneva, which was on March 1st, 2007. Then from 2012 onwards, the UNGA, that is United Nations General Assembly, has declared 21st March as the World Down Syndrome Day from 2012. So this day will be celebrated only on 21st March because, see, the 21st day of third month, that means as it signifies the speciality of triplication, right? Trisomy, third, triplication. So, because they have the extra chromosome, that is 21st chromosome, which causes Down syndrome. So, the several changes in the person, including development as well as physical features, is only because of this chromosome. So, for this only, the 21st March will be celebrated as Down Syndrome Day. Okay, which state? Top forest. So, Maruti. Top forest. Forest cover is more in Madhya Pradesh state, right? Okay. So, this is about the 21st as well as 22nd March current affairs, right? So, if you have any doubts, message me in the comment section as well as share with your friends. So, if you still didn't subscribe to our channel, please do subscribe as well as share this video with your friends. Okay, thank you.